Greetings. Today I'm going to discuss the topic of water baptism. First look at the understanding that many religious practices out there today have of the process of going completely submerged under the water as a symbolism of dying to self and rising again in new life. And that process is, of course, based on repentance, which would be change from our ways. So we're literally agreeing to enter into contract with Yehshua Elohim to turn from our ways and our own understanding and lean on to his ways completely with all of our being. So let's first focus on the subject of John and the wedding feast at Canaan. That was Yeshua's first miracle when he actually turned the water into wine. Everybody's familiar with that story. It's incredible that he used as a vehicle the ritualistic the pots that the Jewish people at that time used for ritualistic cleansing, to be forgiven of their sins, to be cleansed, and that type of thing. And he chose that as a symbolism that has great relevance when we turn to the teachings that he taught us the night before the Passover, when he was instituting some new symbols for his disciples to follow. And he actually gave us the symbol that that the wine is a symbol of his blood. And and if we tie it all together, it really is quite fascinating, because we can't be cleansed from sin by water. We're cleansed by the blood. The scriptures teach that pretty thoroughly. I don't think anyone would doubt that it's the blood that cleanses us. So the process of undergoing baptism, the contract really should be heavy in our hearts about what we're actually agreeing to do. We're actually letting the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, our Messiah, to cleanse us from the sins and when sin is transgressed in the law. So we add that all together, and we should understand the importance of actually changing if we enter into that contract. So it's been reserved until this time. It's pretty straightforward. The water is changed into wine, and he tells us later in the journey, in his journey here before he went to be with the Father, that the wine is a symbol of his blood. And we're also taught that we are cleansed by the blood. So with this understanding now, what we do with it is of great significance, because to take that blood lightly is just no different than taking the name or the character of Yehweh Elohim lightly. If we say that we're his children and we claim to be his children, his begotten children, awaiting for transformation to be into his family, we bear that name. Just like if we make the contract to be cleansed by the blood of Yeshua through the process of repentance and change, we bear that process. We accept that token, that gift of salvation that will lead us into his family. And we begin a process of coming out of Egypt, the deceptions of our own thinking, the deceptions of Satan, the deceptions of the enemy, and of all the false religious teachers out there. So with that, we'll close this video segment, and we'll resume again talking about the false teachers out there and how to identify them.